friends, we all know that now we are celebrating the UN decade of forest land restoration, and in India also we have taken many activities for improving the quality of the forest, mainly ecosystem restoration and forest landscape restoration. But certainly there are some issues in our country which are creating some limitations for such kind of forest restoration activities. Number one, all the lands under 40% coverage density are considered degraded in our country, which is actually not correct. Large part of the areas are under low rainfall area, that is less than 700 mm, and these are in their ecological prime, even though technically they are open forest, and hence most of these lands are not available for the FLR activity. In the open forest, the lands that are actually degraded because of anthropogenic reasons, and a large part of these areas are not available because communities are using these lands for the grazing purposes and other uses, and hence these communities are not allowing these lands to be brought under the dense forest cover. The third point is that in our country we have about 2 million hectares of reserve forest land which have been handed over to the tribes and other forest dependent communities over the last one decade, and much more are assigned to the community recognizing their rights. The tribes are able to establish their rights by showing the degraded nature of the forest, and the open-ended nature of FRA gives hope to the prospective claimant that more of the degraded lands can come to their ownership, and hence there is a sharp opposition to take up restoration activities in such areas. The fourth is that degraded lands in the community-owned forest in the entire northeast region of the country are being rapidly brought under the commercial crop like tea, rubber, and other floriculture activities, which gives quick income to the cultivators, and hence there are reluctance to allow these areas to be considered under forest restoration. And last but not least, we all know that certainly there are lack of resources to undertake restoration activities. This is also one of the main reason in many areas where we have not been able to take up restoration activities. The other point is that we have some lack of awareness about the communities regarding the negative impact of the forest restoration, and there are certain we have limited resources, or we can say that we have lack of funding for the long-term research in the areas of forest land restoration. These are the few points which I wanted to highlight. Thank you very much.